But we got Warren Buffett. He's saying they referring to cryptocurrencies. Warren Buffett said they will come to a bad ending. Just over a year since its 69,000 peak, Bitcoin has plummeted more than 70%. Here's why Warren Buffett has hated cryptocurrency all along. Interesting. Warren Buffett saying it's going to come to a bad ending. Sounds familiar. Remember, he was saying the same thing in the 2019 bear market and made new all-time highs. It's been a year. It's been a tough year for Bitcoin and its backers. Even back in 2018, the Oracle of Omaha predicted that it and other cryptocurrencies were headed for trouble. They will come to a very bad ending. They will come to a very bad ending, Warren Buffett told CNBC at the time. After hitting an all-time peak of 69,000 per unit on November 10th, 2021, the world's leading digital currency has since erased roughly 75% of its value, sitting at 16,600 as the end of trading day on December 19th. Holdout investors who once thought they'd missed an opportunity of a lifetime are now sighing with relief. Meanwhile, those who bought in at the peak are trying not to think about their losses. What would the world's most famous investors say to those who might be thinking of firing up their investment apps and buying Bitcoin at a bargain price? He says, if you owned all the Bitcoin in the world and you offered it to me for $25, I wouldn't take it, Buffett told CNBC earlier this year. What if you offered it for $20? Would he take it? Other than Bitcoin's disappointing track record, here are three more reasons Buffett won't go near it. So one, it has no unique value at all. Again, this is a silly argument, but he says billionaire investors doesn't like Bitcoin because he considers it an unproductive asset. Buffett has a well-known preference for stocks of corporations whose value and cash flow comes from reducing things, but cryptocurrencies don't have real value. Buffett said in a CNBC interview in 2020, they don't reproduce. They can't mail you a check. They can't do anything. And what you hope is that somebody else comes along and pays you more money for them later on. But then that person's got the problem. Though Bitcoin is intended to provide real value as a payment system, that use is still pretty limited as Buffett sees it. Bitcoin's value comes from the optimism that someone else will be willing to pay more for it in the future than they're paying for you today. So Richard Hart talks about this actually, so we could unpack this. So he's saying they don't have real value. They don't reproduce. First of all, hex does reproduce. Okay. Hex gives you more hex. So it does solve that to an extent in an interesting way. But Richard Hart talks about the fact that your Apple stock, your Berkshire Hathaway stock, its value comes from the next person buying higher. I mean, there is this meme that there's a company attached to it. And there's something to it in the sense that they could pay you dividends and they can do buybacks with the cash that they earn. And they're supposed to be doing everything they can to ensure good price performance of the shares. But at the end of the day, the value does come from the next person buying higher. And you have to understand the reality that we live in, where money is not scarce. It is abundant and it has to go somewhere and it can't go into goods and services. I mean, it can't, the excess money, meaning the money that's not spent, meaning that you don't need for goods and services, it can't be spent there because what are you going to store your value in a service? Like, are you going to store your extra money? Are you going to put it into a Verizon cell phone plan? Like when you already have a plan, are you going to put it into Apple's, which goes spoiled? No, you have to put it into the stock market or real estate or now cryptocurrency. And that's why it keeps going up, because more and more money comes into circulation and it has to go somewhere. And that's really why these things go up in value. So he's saying that it's only value is the hope that somebody else comes along and pays more money for them later on. I mean, yeah, that applies to stocks and that applies for crypto. And at the end of the day, yeah, I mean, when you get your autographed baseball from a baseball player, the value is the next person buying higher. It's not priced properly based on its material. It's priced, it is inflated exponentially by this idea that this guy who's good at baseball signed it or something like that. Your Pokemon card, You know, the cardboard is not really what gives it its value. It's like things like that. So when you have crypto, you have a community. They share values. They value something. It has game theory. It has tokenomics. It's scarce. It's going to go up in value from the next person buying higher, like everything else. I mean, that Hex and crypto and Bitcoin, they're not the exception. They're really the rule. So you can sit in your little box and say, oh, it doesn't have any intrinsic value, whatever, from today till tomorrow. But if you didn't get into it, the people, like, you are at a serious loss in comparison to the people that did get into it. So I don't like these, like, circular arguments, these paradigms that people make up in their head for saying it's not worth what it's worth. At the end of the day, it has outperformed every other asset. It has given you the returns that Berkshire Hathaway gave you in 4 decades. It's given you that in one. So you could say from today till tomorrow it doesn't have value. People are willing to pay for it, just like anyone else, just like anything else. You know, people are willing to pay for it. And it has benefited people tremendously. I think the same thing is going to apply to Hex. Albeit most cryptocurrencies are not going to make it. But the ones that do are going to give the people that got in early some serious opportunities. That's really the overall response to that. But no disrespect to Warren Buffett. I think Warren Buffett is a legend. He's a legendary investor. He's a brilliant guy. I mean, he's very charismatic as well. I really enjoy listening to him, and I've really learned a lot from him. But that's really what I'd say about that. And then he doesn't think cryptocurrency counts as money. Obviously, it doesn't. Nobody wants to pay. That's the thing. People think that, like, Bitcoin's going to become the world reserve currency, or like Hex is going to become the world reserve currency. It makes a terrible currency. Would you want to spend your money? Would you want to spend something that goes up 1,000x in a couple of years? Like, no, you don't want to spend it. How could the economy run on a currency that nobody wants to spend? You need, like, you need the 1-2% inflation. I mean, that's really what it comes down to. So yeah, it would make a very poor currency. For a currency, it wouldn't have the price appreciation that it has, and it would lead to stagnation or shrinkage of the economy, because people aren't going to want to spend it. So it doesn't count as a cryptocurrency, and it's for that reason. It doesn't count as a currency, and it's for that reason it's had such good price performance. And he doesn't understand it. Well, yeah, that's pretty straightforward. Don't invest what you don't understand. I actually agree with that 100%, which is why I say do your own research. And this is not financial advice, but it is important to understand something. How are you going to hold on to something when it crashes 90-95%, if you don't understand, if, like, you didn't do the research to understand it? At that point, if you just bought something because it's going up and it's going down, you're going to get rid of it. But if you understand it and you verify and you validate that it is going to go up over a prolonged period of time because it brings in new innovation, you know, it's a great company or a great crypto that's innovative, it's got a community, it's got game theory, it's got a great company, it has the company has a new software or program that they brought into the world that is going to change the world, that is going to reach mass adoption. If you really understand it, you will not be fazed by these massive corrections, which is why you have to understand what you're buying. And if you don't, you're going to get shaken out. There's just no two ways about it. And you can't even blame yourself. Like, if you sold Bitcoin early because you didn't understand it, you can't even blame yourself. Because that's just the way it works. But yeah, that's my thoughts on Warren Buffett. No disrespect to Warren Buffett. We like Warren Buffett. Warren Buffett is, there's a lot to learn from him. I think he's a genius. I think he's done a great job for his shareholders. Shout out to Warren Buffett, but he's dead wrong with cryptocurrency. He's been saying it was going to fail for a very long time. It's been doing very, very well for a long time. So yeah, that was our featured story. Feel free to send a super chat. Feel free to subscribe to the channel and to press the notification and sign up for the newsletter in the description. But we got 48 watching. Thank you for tuning in. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Let's check out the chat. See if you guys have anything to say We got Chad Donnerschwanz. DCA is the way. Very true. Very true. Could not have said it better myself. Todd, oi, 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 oi. you Aussie, you Aussies, and Fijianabanajarans, whatever. Sorry. I cry myself to sleep every night knowing I was considering putting a substantial amount into hex in 2019, but I had no faith. Pray for Pulse. Hey, hey, listen, you think it's over for hex? You think the opportunity's gone? If not, you shouldn't be crying. That's what I'd say about that. And it monetizes the time value of money. So you could feel free to DCA and just throw it down 5, 10, 15 years for compound interest, for astronomical gains, in my opinion, not financial advice. 47 watching, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Seems like that's it. No super chats today, so I'm going to have to cry. I'll have to cry myself to sleep that I didn't get any super chats. But he sacrificed a little for Pulse. That's SMTH. I don't know the lingo. I'm not like with it, like you young whippersnappers, but that's great that you sacrificed. Please like the video. Please subscribe to the video. Please email me at furufinance@gmail.com for a one-on-one tutoring session where I will not give you financial advice, but I can educate you about cryptocurrency, about hardware wallets, anything you want to talk about it, anything you want to talk about, we could talk about. It helps me. It helps support me, and hopefully it could support you. And if you support me, then I could hopefully support you, and it supports everyone. So support me so I can support you, so we can support everyone. And appreciate your content, man. Keep it up. Thank you, bro. I appreciate it. I appreciate you guys watching. Again, please hit the like and subscribe button, and I'll see you guys tomorrow, 12 p.m. Eastern time, talking Hex, Pulse Chain, and Pulse X, Sunday through Fridays, 12 p.m. Put on your notification, like, subscribe. Follow me on Twitter at Furu Finance, and sign up for the Furu Finance newsletter. Until tomorrow at 12, have a great day.